In this video, I'll introduce you to bonding in coordination compounds by looking at the number of unpaired electrons, or unpaired spins, in these complex ions. The first one is CrCn6 4-. What we have to consider is the number of electrons, or unpaired electrons, in just the metal, the chromium metal. And then what we look at is the ligands. That is the stuff that's attached to the transition metal. So the ligand that we have is the cyanide ion. Well, the cyanide ion is what we call a strong field ion, or strong field ligand. And that results in a low spin complex. So if you have a strong field ligand, you get a low spin complex. If you have a weak field ligand, you get a high spin complex. And that'll be the next example. So low spin complex. And here's what that means. It means we have the Cr2+ ion that combines with cyanide to give this complex ion. And the electron configuration is the argon core, and then 3d4. So these four valence electrons in a 3d orbital then looks like this. This is an orbital diagram, and we've got these squares. This is just a typical orbital diagram. And for the low spin complex, what that means, the low spin complex means, is that we have more paired electrons, or paired spins. So we would have up and then down, and then we actually still have two up. So the answer then is two unpaired spins, or unpaired electrons. More typically called unpaired spins. Okay, the next one, CrH2O6 2+. We're going to run through this very similarly. However, H2O, as I foreshadowed, gave you a little warning that the next one is going to be weak field. So H2O is a weak field ligand, and that then results in what we would call a high spin complex. Now we have this same atom, chromium, so the same ion, Cr2+. And so we're dealing with this again, this electron configuration. So we have those four valence electrons, and what's going to happen? Well, we have this same orbital diagram, where we start the same with the boxes. Very technical to call them just the boxes, but what happens with the high spin complex is that nothing is paired. So we've got up and up and up and up, and of course these all have labels, these boxes. But what we're really concerned with is that the D subshell could be filled up to 10 electrons, and so we have available two per box. That's what you could fit in there, and so that's why we could have the 10. But anyway, we have nothing paired there, so the answer here is that we have four, because we just have four valence electrons, so four unpaired spins. And that is the answer for the second example, and I hope that was helpful. If it was, please consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.